Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and in this edition, we have the following topics for you. Qt Desktop Days Recap. Road to Qt 6, Schedule and Recent News. Qt for MCU 1.4. Qt Automotive Suite 5.15.0. KDE DockWidgets 1.0.0 Release. Hotspot and Heaptrack Updated. Event announcements and resources. In the last week, there has been the first Qt Desktop Days hosted by KDAB and supported by many partners from the desktop community. Special thanks to KDE, who helped to set up the technical infrastructure in a very short time. The event wouldn't have happened without their help. I'm glad now to speak with Jesper Pedersen, who hosted the event, to give us a quick recap of what happened and how everything worked out. Hello, Jesper.
Hi, Robert.
How did you like the premiere of this new event focusing on Qt for the desktop?
I love a whole week of focus just on the desktop with Qt, and I think it was a smashing success.
Agreed, especially for a first-time event. Have there been any interesting aspects or observations that you can share with us?
You know what, Robert? This was a virtual conference, and as such, no need for tracks. But I actually identified three major tracks in this conference program nevertheless. Track number one, QML. There was a lot of attention to QML in this conference. I identified at least six presentations about QML. Some of them on how do you migrate from widgets to QML, and others on showcasing QML or showcasing part of the QML design framework. The second track was on testing. We had two very interesting presentations, one on behavior-driven testing. How do you write behavior-driven testing? How do you do that at all? Gee, what does it even mean? I didn't know upfront. And the other one was on code coverage and how do you drive your testing effort there. The last track was on widgets, where we both revisited layouting in general and how do you do that efficiently in large-scale application. We looked at QtWidgets and its new version, KDockWidget. We talked about how we add touch input to our applications that already exist out there. And out of track, you could say it was a fourth track. We had a very, very interesting presentation from Microsoft presenting their Windows subsystem Linux, and they even had a small announcement of what would be in the new Windows Insider program. Very interesting stuff to watch there. I'm not going to go into more details. You can watch the videos once they're out. And finally, we started the whole thing with a keynote where our very own Giuseppe D'Angelo were talking about what's new in Qt 6. The whole show was ended with a Q&A session where the whole audience could ask questions to a number of people that on anything relating to Qt. Lots and lots of very good and interesting questions, both for where we are today and what's going to be in the future.
It really was interesting to see the differences from going virtual and how well it all works with this completely different way of doing things. Thanks a lot, and hopefully we'll see more of this next year.
Well, I hope to see you all at Qt Desktop Days 2021. And for those of you who missed the presentation this year, we did record them all, and we will put them on YouTube as soon as we're done with the post-production. Stay tuned, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you'll be the first to know when they're out there.
Yes, subscribe and hit the old bell to get the notifications. Thanks again, Jesper. At the beginning of September, the Qt company announced the feature freeze for Qt 6. This is an important milestone on the way to the planned release in December 2020. In the meantime, the alpha version is announced to be released in September, the beta version will follow in October, and the release candidate in November. In Qt 6, there will be some significant updates that also impact the underlying way in which the development host OS and the target OS are supported. The most significant changes affecting development hosts and targets include how Qt integrates to the graphics system, the C++ minimum version update from 11 to 17, and the transition from QMake to CMake. Qt 6 will be supported on development hosts familiar for Qt 5 releases, Windows, Linux, and macOS. For Red Hat Linux users, the biggest change is the move of Red Hat's to CentOS in CI. For developers using Windows, only 64-bit Windows 10 is now supported as a host. Additionally, there are minor updates to the latest host operating system versions, with new versions being added and older versions being dropped. Further, there have been a few Qt releases this month. Recently, there was a new release of Qt for MCUs available in the Qt installer. Version 1.4 introduces a new font engine that can display a wider range of text without bloating the memory footprint. The release also includes API improvements and bug fixes, enhancing usability and stability. And earlier in the month, Qt Automotive Suite 5.15.0 was released. It is now available for Qt Automotive Suite license holders via the Qt Online Installer or the Qt Maintenance Tool. Qt Automotive Suite is a spiced-up version of Qt for device creation with additional automotive support features. It also is a special release, as it's the last feature release for the Qt 5 series. Next up in the pipeline, Qt 6, DockDock. KDAB recently released version 1.0 of KDDockWidgets, a framework for custom-tailored docking systems in Qt. It provides advanced docking that QtWS2020 doesn't support. For example, the very precise docking indicators plus the total freedom of docking areas. KDDockWidgets is available both under GPL v2, GPL v3, and under commercial license. You'll find a list with all the features in the link below. New versions of the performance tools Hotspot and Heaptrack have been released. The Heaptrack Fast Heap Memory Profiler allows you to track all heap memory allocations at runtime. The 1.2.0 release brings a couple of important bug fixes and improvements. As a result of these, Heaptrack is more stable and error-resistant while recording data. Hotspot, on the other hand, is a replacement for perf reports that takes a perf data file, parses and evaluates its contents, and then displays the results in a graphical form. With the 1.3.0 release, it has become much faster at interpreting data for large, complex applications. So, analyzing perf data files for Firefox, for example with its monster libxul, is now magnitudes faster than it was in the previous releases of Hotspot. The agenda for QtWS2020 Summit 2020 is now online. There's going to be a broad variety of talks across four tracks, and Lars Noll's Qt 6 keynote will hopefully be full of new and interesting information on the release. Last week, there was the KDE Akademy. The first ever KDE Akademy online was a great success, with attendance this year exceeding real-time annual figures, without counting streaming observers. So, not being able to meet in person does have its upsides. The recreational escape games were a lot of fun too, if I can get out of this room. Find out more in the report from our colleagues, link below. There's a new video tutorial series about Qt widgets development. Other than in previous series, there will be added single videos over time showing Qt widget developers some best practice, tools, and other useful tips. Last month, I recommended a white paper about containerization on embedded systems. On the 23rd of September, our partner Toradex is offering a free webinar about that topic. Check it out if you are developing embedded software. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. See you next time.